We are going to see about biopolymers. Nowadays, so many problems in our environment because we are use the synthetic polymer. Synthetic polymers are non-degradable and pollute the soil. Synthetic polymer example, plastic, nylon, polyester, etc. Now, so effort were taken to provide an alternative eco-friendly biopolymers. Namely, PHA and PHB. PHA, polyhydroxy alkanoates. Second one, PHB, polyhydroxy butyrate. Or group of degradable biopolymers. Then we have several medical applications such as drug delivery and heart valves. The production of PHA, the several microorganisms have been utilized to produce different type of PHA, including gram-positive and gram-negative bacteria. Gram-positive bacteria, Bacillus megaterium and Bacillus subtilis. Gram-negative bacteria, group of Pseudomonas species. Then, another one biopolymers, Palylactic acid. Palylactic acid or palylactide is a biodegradable and bioactive thermoplastic. This also the biodegradable and bioactive thermoplastic. The PLA is an aliphatic polyester derived from renewable resources. Renewable and non-renewable resources, all of you know. The renewable resources such as cornstarch, cassava root means tapioca root and sugarcane. The production of palylactic acid, they used to two main monomer. First one, lactic acid, then cyclic diester lactide. The including the form of palylactic acid. The palylactic acid, the polymerization ring opening. The palylactic acid, the most common route is the ring opening polymerization of lactide with metal catalyzed like tin octavate in solution. Palylactic acid product. Then next topic, green fluorescent protein. Green fluorescent protein, GFP. The green fluorescent protein containing 238 amino acid residues. The green fluorescent protein containing 238 amino acid residues that exhibit bright green fluorescence when exposed to blue to ultraviolet range 395 nanometer. Protocol for green fluorescent protein. The green fluorescent protein isolated from Aquaria victoria jellyfish. The green fluorescent protein isolated from Aquaria victoria, then using the gene splicing technique, using gene splicing technique altering the codon, then GFP introduced into Arabidopsis thaliana plant. Arabidopsis thaliana plant, Brassicaceae family and a herb flowering plant. Then GFP expressed in Arabidopsis thaliana plant. GFP expressed in Arabidopsis thaliana plant. This jellyfish. Then GFP isolated from jellyfish. Then introduced into Arabidopsis thaliana plant. The green fluorescent protein is an excellent tool in biology due to its ability to form internal chromophore without requiring any accessory cofactors, gene product, enzyme or substrate other than molecular oxygen. So, the GFP is an excellent tool in biology due to the form of the internal chromophore without requiring any accessory cofactor, gene product, enzyme or substrate other than molecular oxygen. Only use the molecular oxygen, only use the GFP. So, due to the excellent tool in biology. Then, in cell and molecular biology, the GFP gene is frequently used as a reporter of expression. The GFP has been used in modified forms to make biosensors.